Hey, this is Jason DeLong with Jana Company Real Estate Experts here in Kansas City, and welcome to our video blog. Today, I wanted to say Happy Halloween and to go over some tips and tricks for keeping the place safe for those little trick-or-treaters. I know in our family, we love Halloween, and both the kids, we like dressing up and just having fun with the whole holiday, mostly because of the kids, but you can always tell about a month before Halloween hits where my wife, who is like a big kid, and our 11-year-old son, Landon, try to scare each other back and forth. And I'd be lying if I said I didn't join in the fun. So anyway, Happy Halloween. And let me go over a few things to keep your house safe for those little trick-or-treaters. First, if you're decorating your front porch and front door by putting scary things out there or jack-o'-lanterns, lighting those with candles, putting fog, keep those things in mind, like little trip hazards. Candles, try to use the electric candles instead of the ones with the flame. That might help keep it a little bit safer. Secondly, I know it's trying to create a scary environment on that night and it gets dark quicker, but try to make sure the pathways are lit. If you have pathway lights or something that you could put to at least make sure they can get up and down to your front door and back safely, that's one of the things you might look for. Another thing, up around the front porch, front door, wherever you're handing out candy, anything that's valuable, breakable, try to remove those or move them out of the way. So like big flower pots that can get knocked over, move those out of the way. That would keep everyone safe and make sure that you're not having a costly damage or repair. And another thing is buy plenty of candy. I know a lot of people run out of candy and still have like an hour of trick-or-treaters left and have to turn the lights out and turn kids away. So it's funny, they actually have like the top 20 trick-or-treat cities. Kansas City did not make that list, which I don't know how, but anyway, if you have a active neighborhood and plan a lot of trick-or-treaters, make sure you have plenty of candy so you don't run out, because I'm sure that stuff can get eaten down the road if you do have extras. So get plenty of candy. And lastly, you don't want to be a buzzkill if you're handing out candy. So wear a costume or dress up, do something, then just come to the door in a sweater and some jeans, because kids want to see, adults dressing up or do something, tell a joke, anything to just keep the kids' interest and add to the experience. So anyway, those are the tips and tricks for keeping the house safe, the front door, the front porch safe for trick-or-treaters. So hope you guys enjoy your Halloween, and as always, look forward to hearing from everybody. And as always, if you have any questions about buying or selling, please reach out, email or phone call, and we'd love to talk to you.